Are you a person that has always wondered how you can get into developing your own film, but are worried about like the size of space that you need or potentially like how to do it reliably as a beginner? I have that answer for you. What's up, everybody? My name's Brandon. My friends call me Ferg, and today I want to show you my one secret that lets me develop film photos in a way that is reliable and also concise enough to do so in a Toronto basement apartment. For context, a couple of weeks ago, I put out some photos on my Instagram story and people were like, "Ooh, Ferg, how did you do those things?" And I says to them, "Well, they're film photos that I developed myself." And people said, "Ferg, how do you go about developing your film photos?" And I want to answer that in this particular video. So the solution is quite simple because of this little piece of kit right here. This is called a lab box, and essentially what it lets you do is develop film photos in a way that is super reliable, super light, safe, and beginner friendly. It replaces traditional Patterson tanks with this small, concise package, and unlike Patterson tanks where you had to use either dark rooms or changing bags to facilitate film going from the canister to onto the actual reel that you were using for development, this does all that in a very small package. The reason why I chose this over a traditional Patterson tank is for the reason that it felt way more reliable and safe to just jump into the film development process without having to worry about being perfect in the way that you get the film off the roll and into the actual tank. So I picked up this, a film leader retriever, which essentially lets you draw film off of the actual roll and then feed it into this tank. And you use a little crank from there, and that's what actually winds the film off of the film roll into the actual tank. From there, you do all your chemistry and you're developing things in here, you time accordingly, and it's a really simple process of like pouring things in, waiting the time, agitating as necessary, and pouring things back out. So this is kind of what makes everything super possible. And like I said, this footprint is extremely, extremely small. You don't need a dark room. You don't even need a changing bag, and you don't need all of the space that you would have to actually fold out to get things done. Like, I've never used a changing bag, but I've seen reviews of them online, and essentially you have to like feel in the dark in a bag. You can't see your hands at all. And that's how you have to get the film. You have to pop the film thing open and then you gotta get it onto the tank. Whereas you can see everything super tactilely here without fear of exposing things to light, which again, if you're working really hard for those film shots and you start to capture some really great stuff, I like the reliability and the safety of knowing that everything is super light proof and you don't have to worry about guessing or scratching your film in a bag as you bumble around like a monkey. Anyway, that is kind of my secret. That's how I develop photos in a way that's reliable and fairly succinct and concise and that fits in my closet. I can do this anytime, anywhere. I could do it on the road. I could do it in the field. I could do it in the middle of traffic for all I care. It's safe and it's gonna make sure that my photos, my hardly earned exposures, don't get blown by clumsy transfers. I'm making this video because you as an audience asked for it. A lot of you responded to my Instagram story asking like how I got my film photos done. And this is my response to that. I'd love to continue to make this kind of content, but I want to make sure it's content that matters to you and it's going to serve you. So if you found this valuable, please like leave me a comment, let me know, send me a DM, because I'd love to continue to connect you with content that helps you on your path to filmmaking and photo taking. I hope you found this at least helpful. And if you have any other questions about how you can get away with developing film photos in a way that is small, concise, and precise, let me know. Shoot me a message. Until then, peace.